Hello everyone, it's me, Raphael. Today in English, because this video is especially for my friends at the Brucey Central Elementary School. And in this video, I will show you the Fool's Mate. And the Fool's Mate is a game of chess, and it's the shortest game of chess that is possible. It will only last two moves. Yeah, really, only two moves. And the game by itself is not so important, but the motif, the position that will occur, that is important. And it's important that you could remember it, that you could recall it in playing chess, and especially in the opening. And so the Fool's Mate is not so important, because we didn't play against fools every time, but it's important for your chess. And so let's see. Normally, in chess, especially in the opening, it's important to control the center. That is the main goal. And the easiest way is to place a pawn there. So, pawn e5, e4 would be good. Black would play pawn e5. It's a good way to start the game. It's also possible to play d4 and d5. There are also openings where you try to control the center on the diagonal. That is also possible. So for example, with a bishop. But a beginner, how should he know it? So he will just start and grab one of his pawns and perhaps will grab this. You could argue perhaps this pawn also controls a square of the center, so it's not a bad move. It's not the best move, of course not. It has also a name. This opening is called Barnes opening or Geduld's opening. And black will just develop normally. And now the big mistake, g4. And now it's black to move and to win. And that is already the end of the Fool's Mate or the Fool's Game. Because what is the move for black? You always have to watch out for checks and captures first. It's queen h4. And that is mate. The king cannot escape. He's always in check. You cannot block it. No piece can block it, and you could not capture it. You could try it, but it will not work. It's also illegal. So that is mate. Only two moves and white is mate. What can we learn from it? We can learn from it that this diagonal from h4 to e1, it's really dangerous. It's dangerous for your king. King safety is the most important in the opening. And we weakened this diagonal by playing f3 and g4. And that was a big mistake. We see why. The Barnes opening is serious. You could play it, but you should not play g4. You should play here knight h3. That would be a good move. And when he attacks it, you retreat to f2. And the meaning behind this move is you control this square, perhaps castling, and then e3, d3, c3. So you wait. What will black do? And then you try to counterattack. That is not a good opening because it's too passive. So black has the whole board. Black can develop his pieces easily to active squares. And you are not, you are only standing on three wings. So that is for, perhaps good for blitz or for bullet, but not for, for classic chess. Or it's just an opening to surprise your opponent. Is it possible to win with the fool's mate also with white? Yeah, it is possible, but it will last a little bit longer. So let us start with a better move. So let us start with e4. That is the best move for beginners because you control the center and you open the way for your pieces. So the bishop could come out, the knight could come out, you could castle early. So that would be a perfect opening. And now black plays f6. Perhaps you wanted to prevent that the pawn will continue on his way. Now white controls all these central squares. That is a good thing. And he can also develop his pieces easily. And if you have space behind your pawns, that will help you to develop your pieces easily. So it's always good if your opponent is a fool. Just take the chance and put your pawns in the center and control the whole center. Now the move g5, and now it's again white to move and to win. And it's again queen h5 mate. Also, if black plays here h6, it's also mate. It's the same mate. You can block it, of course, but now it's still mate. So the fool's mate is also possible against black. But it will last one move longer. But it's okay. So why is it so important? It's important to picture, to have this picture in your mind and to memorize it and remember it, recall it in openings that you should not weaken the diagonal to your king. King safety is the most important thing in the opening. And you could really, really easily lose a game, perhaps not after 2 moves, but perhaps after 10 moves, if you weaken your king in this way. Can we find this motif also in more normal openings? Okay, let us see. If we play e4, the king's pawn opening, and black reacts with e5. Here you could play a gambit, the king's gambit. Gambit because you sacrifice a pawn for fast development. So let's see how it works. Black takes a pawn. A pawn is a pawn. And now white has the whole central, controls the whole central, and he tries to recapture his pawn with a bishop. And then fast development. So for example, knight out, bishop out, castling, and then the rook is already on this open file. Attack, attack, attack. That is the king's opening. But white plays it here a little bit, yeah, too aggressive. That is called the Polerio gambit, because he weakened his king. And black can use it to his advantage. How? Just queen h4. And now it's difficult to defend. What should you do? If you block it, Black just takes the pawn. And now if you block it, he continues. He attacks your king and he attacks your knight. A double attack. So you could not save both. Now your queen is under attack. The queen retreats. And if you look at this position, it looks like here's something exploded and Black's position is all in order. So that would be catastrophic for White. And the reason was because White weakened his king. The right move here would be to move your king up. So now you will not lose material and perhaps you could attack and win a tempo on the queen. But the easiest way for Black is here to check and protect your pawn. And now you are a clear pawn up. Black is just a clear pawn up and White could ask himself, why is my king standing here? So all the pieces are blocked by the king. So that would be a success. That would be an error. And that is also the same motif that we saw in the Fool's Game. That is the small, the short diagonal to the king, h4 to e1. And that is important to remember. You cannot weaken your king. King safety is extremely important in the opening. And here we saw why. Let us also start with the queen's pawn. So d4. Normal responses would be d5 or knight f6. That would be normal. There are also interesting defenses for Black that are not so common. And that would be, for example, Benoni or the Dutch defense. And there are different ways to play against the Dutch, but one would be, for example, bishop g5. And if Black attacks it, we retreat. And if Black attacks it again and threatens to capture our bishop, then we have a trap. And this trap we only know because of the fool's mate. Because we know the fool's mate, we also know this trap here. And the good move here is just e3. And Black thinks, hey, wow, I won a bishop. So just take it. But how will win White? White to move and win? How? Pause the video. First, check for all checks and captures. And here it's again mate. That is the fool's mate. That is why the fool's game or the fool's mate is so important to know. That you not fall for this trap. So Black was obvious a fool. Okay, Black saw it and prevents it. Now there is no mate. How will we continue? Should we rescue our bishop? No, we can develop our other bishop to e2 and say, come on, take the bishop. And what now? Again, White to move and win. I show it. It's check. He captures, we capture, and it's mate again. That is again the fool's mate. So if we go back to our fool's game, this game is not really important. It's not important to know this game. It's only important to picture this position and store it in your database and that you are able to recall it and that you know king safety is important. You cannot weaken the diagonal to your king. You cannot weaken your king so much. King safety is one of the most important things in the opening, and therefore it's important to remember this fool's mate, because in real life we will not play fools all the time. So thanks, see you next time, bye bye.